A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 16th Feb, on the front page you have India revokes Pakistan's MFN status, that is most favored nation status, day after terrorist strike in Jammu and Kashmir. So this is the MFN status, the trade relations status, which is provided, which is mandated under the World Trade Organization. But India has now revoked the MFN status for Pakistan. You should know that Pakistan has not accorded us MFN status, but we had, and now we have revoked it. So it has warned of more measures in response to the Pakistan's support for terrorist groups targeting India. Then this is CJI blames lawyers for delay in listing Rafael petitions. So this is errors in document which are yet to be set right. So the listing of Rafael petitions, the government had filed petitions too. There are separate review petitions which have been filed against the Supreme Court's order. So the CJI is blaming the lawyers now for delaying the listing of the petitions. Then below you have sedition charge a conspiracy, AMU Students Union. So students are continuing protests in Aligarh Muslim University. They're demanding withdrawal of the sedition charges and rustication of BJP MLA's grandson. So this is regarding the sedition charges which were slapped against some students. And this is Vande Bharat, India's fastest train takes off. So this is the Vande Bharat train which has been inaugurated now, the Vande Bharat Express. So it was flagged off by the Prime Minister. It is called the engineless train. It has self-propelled coaches. So that is this Train 18 as it was earlier called. On page 2 you have challenge to Ayodhya Act posted before Supreme Court bench. So there is a petition which is challenging the Ayodhya Act. It is challenging the legislative competence of Parliament to acquire religious land. And on page 5, you have this detailed coverage on Vande Bharat Express, which was earlier called, Train 18. So its maximum speed is 160 km per hour. Below you have Gaganyaan's review panel to meet in March. So this is Indian Space Research Organization which is going to share space mission details of Gaganyaan to various stakeholders. So it's a national review committee on Gaganyaan which will meet for the first time on 5th and 6th March. So it will comprehensively cover the entire details of the first Indian human mission to space, Gaganyaan. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Terrible Thursday. So this is regarding the Pulwama attack. So it says, as the investigation into Pulwama attack begins, Pakistan must act against the Jaish-e-Mohammed, which has claimed responsibility for the attack. And this is Forever President. So this is regarding Egypt. So in Egypt, Mr. Sisi, as such, the president of Egypt, Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, he stands to extend his reign if Egypt's draft constitutional changes go through. So he wants to be president for a long time. We have already seen how through a revolution, the Egyptian people had removed the president, long-standing president, and through reforms, through the revolution, this had come forth. And now we see again that a president wants to continue to be president for long through constitutional amendments. Then this, the lead article is Hindutva 2.0 is in crisis. So this is Prime Minister Narendra Modi's winning formula of 2014, which is said to be under severe stress. So this is again politics. Then this is heralding a new dawn. So this is regarding India and Saudi Arabia. So Prince Mohammed bin Salman is on a visit to countries in Asia and is going to visit India too. And this talks about India-Saudi Arabia relations with respect to how Saudi Arabian reforms are having, its consequences on India and even with respect to oil and other aspects of the trade relations, bilateral relations. Then on the op-ed page you have ground zero coverage, because every Saturday you have this ground zero coverage on one particular aspect. So today it is regarding Silk Route. It says the Silk Route was an unhindered stream of trade that built bridges between cultures until it was broken up by the rise of national borders. So it is a Russian plumber and a German nurse who passed through this route. So basically Silk Route passed through China and the northern parts of India. So it was a prominent trade route which China is also trying to revive through the new Silk Route, as it is called, the Belt and Road Initiative. On page 8, you have no change in China's stance. So India is seeking support of China to designate Jaish e Mohammed chief Maulana Masood Azhar as a global terrorist. And earlier we have seen how China had been, you know, blocking this, supporting Pakistan. So China reiterated that it stood by a UN ban on the Pakistan-based terror group Jaish e Mohammed, but stopped short of reversing its stance against sanctioning its chief as a global terrorist. So that is it. And this is the entire detail regarding MFN status. What does it mean? So it's very important. You should know about this. Most favored nation status. So it actually means that the other country would be treated equally as all others. So every country should be equally favored. So that's what World Trade Organization rules require countries to do. They should not discriminate between trading partners. So that is why every country is afforded this most favored nation status, MFN status. So if one country is given any concession, others should also be given those same concessions. So every country should be having the same favors. Then this is, why only bureaucrats on information panels, asked Supreme Court. So this is regarding, you know, Right to Information Act provisions, that is the Central Information Commission and State Information Commissions, which are established under the RTI Act. So it has been seen that in these bodies, there has to be, you know, information professionals who should be appointed, but only bureaucrats fill up these panels. So this has been questioned in the Supreme Court. The petition has been filed on this. Then on page 9, you have this detailed coverage on the Pulwama attack. How the suicide bomber set off a huge cache of RDX. This was around 100 to 150 kg of explosive that was used. On international page, you have Trump declares emergency to build border wall. So this is the announcement which transforms a highly charged policy dispute into a fundamental confrontation over separation of powers. So now to build the wall, along USA-Mexico border, President Donald Trump has declared a national emergency at the border. And this says, US may extend March 1 tariff deadline, says Trump. So American negotiators have briefed Chinese president about the progress. So that is regarding the retaliatory tariffs which in USA and China were, you know, imposing against each other. So now it is said that USA may extend the tariff deadline, which is March 1. Then on business page, you have a news here, merchandise trade deficit widens to 14.73 billion in Jan. So imports of gold and silver have also surged. So this is a trade deficit. And on page 12, you have whistleblower makes fresh charges in Fortis matter. So, you know, he claims in a letter to SEBI that real beneficiaries of fund transfer were top officials managing business of Religare Group. So this is again a whistleblower giving the details about that going on in Fortis Hospital management. On the last page, you have antibiotic resistant NDM1 gene found in pristine Arctic. So this is regarding NDM1 gene, which has been named after New Delhi. So this gene has now, which is an antibiotic resistant gene, has now been found in pristine Arctic. So it has spread there. Scientists are surprised by this detection. It was first isolated in India and hence named so. So it is one of, it is now present in one of the Earth's most remote spots. And this is NASA heading back to the moon. So NASA is planning to arrange short stays on the lunar surface. So it is having these plans to return Americans to the moon. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com in the current affairs section. So here you can see the detailed current affairs coverage with PDF is provided here, which can be downloaded, and monthly compilations can also be downloaded. Plus also the current affairs course, there is a detailed current affairs video course which can be enrolled for, details are here. So that is it. Thank you.